Microsoft Excel can help us to work on student results quickly. So we are going to see how we can create a Microsoft Excel document, type the name of student, their exam scores, their test scores, then we'll see how we can calculate the totals, calculate the percentage of the exam scores. So let's begin. You can just right click on the desktop here. So you're going to create a new Excel file. So when you right click, go to new, and you go to Microsoft Excel worksheet. Then you click that one. So student records, you can name it. Just start typing student records. So you have created an Excel file and saved it on the desktop. That is what we just did. So you can just double tap it. So that is how you can create and save a Microsoft Excel document. Now let's see how we can now enter the student's information. So we want to have some numbering here. Then we want to have the name of the student here. Then we want to have the score for the test. Maybe we have three tests, so we are going to merge three cells. So to merge the cells, just click on the first one here, then hold down the left mouse button and drag. If it is three, four, so select three cells, then you click merge and center. So you can just test one, then we have test two, and then we have test three. Now, when you come here, total of scores, score total, any way you want to name it. Then, when you come here, you can just type maybe exams, exam score. Then, when you come here, you can type the percentage you want to find, maybe 70% of the exam scores. And when you come here, maybe total, just total. It means exams, 70% of exams plus the total score for the test. Good. Now you can just select this and merge it. Merging center, merging center, merging center. The same thing to this one too, like that. Right, it will be well formatted. Select the two, merging center. Good. You see that this one is not showing well. You just have to come here, come to the top here. Make sure that the arrow turns double arrow, or make sure that the cursor turns a double arrow. Then you drag it, expand that column small. The same thing, yeah, like that. Good. So let's number the students. Let's say student one, student two, student three. One thing about Excel is that you don't have to type everything. You can just auto-complete. So you drag it. Then you release. So it has finished numbering for you. Then let me also expand these columns more so that I can type the name of the students here. So I have student one, student two, student three. Well, I don't have to type all these student one, student two, so I can just again select the first one, then drag to the third one or to the last one there. I can just click here and drag to student 10. So it has auto completed it for me. Now you can enter the test scores. Enter the test scores. So maybe So after I finish entering the test course, you have to now calculate the total of the scores. So to do that, you come to this first cell here, then you type equal to. You are telling Excel that you're coming to do some calculation. So what calculation is it? You want to add this, this, and this. So you can just do that. Select it, then type plus. Select this one, type plus again. Select this one, then press equal to. That is one way you can do it. Another way you could do it is that you come here, press equal to, then type sum. Then double click this. Then you click here. Then come and press. You can, after clicking it, you can drag it to this last one here. Then you close the parenthesis, press equal to. It has summit. So you don't have to repeat it for all of them. What you have to do is that you can just hold down the small box there and drag it down to calculate the sum for you. Now let's say the exam scores. So you can take your time to type the exam scores. Perhaps you want to find 70%. So what you have to do is just click here, then type equal to, then select this particular cell, then use the asterisk. That is 8, shift plus 8 on the keyboard. Then you times it by 70%, 0.7. Then you release it or you press enter. So it has calculated it for you, 70%. Now you just have to come here, drag this small box down to calculate the rest for you. So you see Excel is doing it quick for us. Now to find the total, press equal to, you want to find the total of this and this. So that's it. Now you can just drag this one down. Yeah. So Excel has summed this column and these columns for us. Now remember to save your document by clicking here. So it has saved, or by clicking Ctrl plus S, it will save the document for you. If you want to format further, you can just select it. If you want to bolden it, you can do that. You want to change the fonts to anything you want, you can do that. Or the font size, you can increase them. Or the color, you can change the color as well. You can also change the font size here if you want it. You can change this one too if you want. Remember to occasionally save your work by clicking here or Ctrl plus S. Then you can close it. After closing it, you can open it another time and it will be intact.